Yeah. Can we just go back to the simple kind of living? Can we just go back and maybe start from the beginning? Back to better days when love was forgiven. Can we just go back to the way we were?
Welcome to Generations. This is our Thanksgiving special, and we are so glad that you're joining us today. We're here with Ashley. And Ashley, we have the queen with us.
Wow.
Mom, she's here. She's back.
She really is a part of this show.
So glad to have you back.
So
I'm
glad
so thankful that you're here.
So
you know,
glad.
Me and Ashley, we both live in Nashville, and Mom is in Detroit, Michigan, our home, and so she has joined us here and there on Zoom, but we have her live and in color, and boy, don't you look beautiful.
What an honor.
How you been?
Doing good, thank
good,
the Lord.
Good. Well, you know, this holiday, we focus a lot on food, and it makes us all smile, huh, Ashley?
Why it's the best holiday, Thanksgiving.
So joining us throughout the show is Chef Q, from Q1227. It's an awesome restaurant in Sacramento, California. So if you're ever in that area, you don't want to miss the opportunity of going to this restaurant. We have been there a couple of times now, and every time we leave, we are more than satisfied. It is such a blessing. But before we go further with the food, we're going to start with the scripture. And that is 1 Chronicles 16:8. And it says, oh, give thanks to the Lord. Oh, let's be excited about this, right? Full of enthusiasm. Mm-hmm. Oh, give thanks to the Lord. Call upon his name. Make known his deeds among his peoples. And that is what we're doing. That's really what this show is about, Generations, is making known his deeds. Because God is good.
Yes,
and we
is.
Know he's worthy to be praised every day, not just the holiday season.
Right.
But we have so much to be grateful for and to be thankful for. So I'm glad you guys are watching. Call your friends, call your neighbors, call your family, and tell them to tune in to Generations. All right. Let's talk about food.
Ooh. Yes, something I'm very grateful for.
Happy Thanksgiving, family. Happy Thanksgiving.
Welcome.
How are you doing?
Oh,
what
great
an
night.
Honor to be here, guys.
Great. All the way from Sacramento.
All the way from Sacramento, California.
This looks amazing.
Thank you, guys.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you, Chef.
This is awesome. Thank you.
Thanks for being
I'm
here.
I'm on your show. Great.
Finally made it to the show.
So glad that you're here. Okay, this is so cute. This is like,
yeah, what
this
is this?
This is
beautiful.
Already elevated. I've never seen this at my Thanksgiving table.
Yeah, our food does not look like this at Thanksgiving.
So how can we elevate Thanksgiving this
year?
Well,
you can just take a regular salad. This is a field green salad. What
field
we did
salad.
Was we put it in a Parmesan cheese basket, and the entire basket is edible. We did a cherry pear vinaigrette, and on the bottom of your plate there, we have roasted heirloom tomatoes. Mm. I mean, you talk about elevating Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
This is a simple way to do it, because you can do those baskets ahead of time.
And they're
beautiful.
And
then you can just put your salad inside.
So what kind of cheese is this?
That's Parmesan cheese.
So you just put it in the pan. I saw you
put it in a pan, and then you find a mold, and you just let it fall over a mold. We used a bowl here.
Wow.
So it's absolutely divine.
Can I eat this? Can I taste this?
You can eat everything on that plate.
Well, we're going to do that. We're so glad you're here.
You guys enjoy.
Now, what's happening later? Are you going to...
You know what? I'm going to go ahead and make an entree for you. Yes, there's more.
Oh, wow.
We talk about elevating Thanksgiving. So I got a dish in that kitchen that I'm going to bring out for you.
Okay. All right.
It's not traditional, but we're going to elevate it.
You got it.
Enjoy your salad. I'll be back.
Thank you. Thank you,
Shay. I'm going to dig in right now.
Okay, I don't want to have.
It's too pretty to eat.
I know I don't want to mess up the bowl, but I do love cheese. So we have.
And I don't want green in my teeth as we finish the show.
We have walnuts and we have apples and I think he said this is feta.
Mm-hmm.
Is this feta or blue cheese?
And it's beautiful. You look all the colors.
Beautiful.
All of the fall colors are in it. So
that's a good idea to make the bowl something edible. And
yes.
It seemed like it was pretty simple.
So beautiful.
Ooh, it's really good.
So we're going to talk
about
it. I'm
very hungry.
Okay, yeah. He's making all the noises and everything
to
going
to.
Stop eating the food.
She's not eating just for herself. She's eating for two.
Oh, that's
I am eating for two, everyone.
That's right.
There's There's so another baby on the way.
Enjoy yourself.
Make that announcement. Yes.
We just found out yesterday that it's a girl. So I'm having a girl next.
So Wyatt has got a...
Wyatt's getting a sister.
Yes, he's going to be a big brother. So he's got to, share the attention a little bit.
I think he's going to love being a big brother to a sister because, well, he likes babies. So he's always like,
of course.
Baby. And he'll be kissing all over her.
Of course.
And I loved having an older brother. So I'm happy for her that she's going to have Wyatt as an older brother.
And actually, it's going to be really about the same time frame. Yeah. You and Alvin are 2 years apart.
Yeah, we're 2 years and 2 months.
She did everything like you did.
She just repeated.
I guess I'm just
trying
to follow in your footsteps. So they'll be 2 years and 3 months apart. So almost exactly the same distance.
Wow.
Well, Mom, yeah. I'm so glad to have you here.
I'm so glad to be here.
This is probably one of your favorite topics, and that is just being grateful.
Oh, my goodness.
I mean,
Oh my goodness.
We have so many reasons to be grateful.
So many.
I know I told you to bring some notes if you wanted to, so if you want to put that on that side so you can.
Yeah, so many. There are so many things to be grateful for.
I know,
Ashley.
You can't
think of them all. But certainly one of the best comes in John 3:16. Says God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son.
His only begotten Son.
That whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
Yeah.
Can you find anything more
to be grateful for than that? No.
Definitely not.
And that's so huge, Mom, because so many times we look for material things.
Right.
And we forget the main thing that God did, how blessed we are, all of us, everybody. Because God loves everybody. He loves you, he loves me, no matter where you are or what you've done.
He
set a plan in place for all of us to be blessed before, you know, at the beginning of time, you know, and he gave his only begotten Son. So he gave us life.
Yes, he did. Right? Certainly, I am grateful that God saved me.
Yeah.
Grateful for the blood of Jesus that saves all of us from sin, gives us eternal life.
Yeah.
I had a couple of scriptures here.
You want to set it up on there or you want me to take it?
You can take it.
Okay. Let me take it and read it and I give it back to you.
Because I'm glad, you know, as I said, for salvation. And I'm certainly glad that my salvation is sure.
Definitely.
It's sure.
It's a sure foundation.
A sure foundation.
Don't have to keep rechecking. It's done.
Yes. Jesus said that we're in his hands.
Yeah.
He's given us eternal life.
Yeah.
Can you just imagine? Whatever happens here, we're in his hand as it's a sure salvation.
Yeah,
Because he said, if you're in my hand, nobody, no man can pluck you out.
Yeah, that's John 10:28. It says, I am in God's hand. And Jesus said that I give them eternal life and they shall never perish. And listen, neither shall any man pluck them out of my hand.
We can't be plucked out of his hand.
That's
good. Sure salvation.
Very encouraging.
Good. Years ago when he saved me, and I gave my life to him, and I promised to live for him, he gave me a sure salvation. Nobody can take that away.
Nobody can take
it
away.
That's awesome.
Nobody.
Yeah.
And so I'm grateful for that. And certainly, like I said, there are many things to be grateful for. I'm grateful for the life that I have here, that I've had with my husband and all my children. Yeah. The life that he gave me here was enough to be grateful for.
Yeah, I know. You remember the song that Andre Crouch sang, a song called It's Been Worth Just Having the Lord in My Life?
Just having the Lord in my life.
Yeah.
But I still want that, you know,
that eternal life.
Yeah, I still want that.
But he said, but also he had a song where if heaven wasn't promised to me, it's
and
still
that's an
been
if.
Yeah, yeah, but it is.
But it is.
Thank you, God.
And I want everything God promised.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, you and Dad, you were married for how long?
55 and a half years before he went home to be with the Lord.
Wow.
And we got to see a lot of things happening with our children.
Mm-hmm.
I've been left here to see more than he did. He didn't see any of the great-grandchildren.
Oh, wow.
But the Lord has left me here to see that.
Yeah.
So I am eternally grateful.
Yeah. You've seen a lot of those prayers be answered.
Yes. Yeah. Wow. Answered down through the generations.
Down through the generations. That's awesome.
Because God said it was not just for us, but it's for our children and our children's children.
Yeah.
What was Thanksgiving like growing up in the Winans' home?
Boy, it was a week long getting things ready.
Yeah, how many hours would you say
how
you
many
had to
days?
Pray? Yeah, how many days did you have to
because
prep?
It was you, Grandma, who else would help cooking?
Well, it was mostly just me and
yeah,
her.
You wow. and Grandma. Yeah.
And it would be at y'all's house?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes.
Wow. It would usually be at our house, but she'd bring a lot of things. Thank God for her.
Yes.
This is Dad's mom. Yeah. Okay. I mean, Granddad's mom.
Yeah. Yep.
Oh, man. Wow.
And we just would cook up dinner. We'd cook up things we could put in the refrigerator. And,
yeah. You had
the
a plan.
Next day, we had a plan.
You had to have a plan with all of us. To.
And I'm
all
guessing the kitchen wasn't very big.
Oh, no, it wasn't big.
No. The house one wasn't oven. Very big.
She said the house wasn't big.
One oven, those we have all these luxuries now.
Oh
double
my God.
Ovens.
Yeah.
And
you're right,
all
Ashley.
All these extra freezers and
that
I'm just
I don't
trying
know
to,
how to use.
Just trying to imagine this.
That's
simple,
true.
Small kitchen and how many mouths to feed over Thanksgiving.
But on our traditional ovens, we
that's
had
right. They did it all.
Delicious food.
Yeah, delicious.
They did it all.
I'd love to go back in time and taste some of this food. You always
and it
talk
was
about Grandma
pretty
Lara's
too.
Food.
Grandma Lara, moms. I mean, and of course we did everything. We did the chitlins. I never
she
ate
did
the chitlins.
She
did the chitlins. Did you eat chitlins?
Yes.
You loved them too.
Them.
Well, she made them because she cleaned them real good and seasoned them. So most of our audience will probably have to go and research what that is.
Yeah, I can't say I've indulged.
You might get grossed
chitlins.
Out, but hey, somehow they made it where they all loved it.
Oh,
But then it was, it was everything. Turkey, ham.
Ham,
dressing,
beef.
Oh, my goodness. All the pies and cakes.
Well,
y'all
I'm
did it
getting
all.
Hungry.
We did it
you
all.
Say, getting hungry, ready to eat some
I'm
more.
I'm going
to
eat some more of this salad while you
but
guys
just,
talk
again,
about...
just talk about gratitude. So you're grateful for life. You're grateful for, first of all, salvation. Because that is the greatest gift of all.
That's right.
That's the greatest miracle. Mm-hmm. Salvation.
That's
Let me
it.
Make that very plain. This is why we can be grateful no matter what's going on in our lives.
Yeah.
It's not predicated on everything being perfect and every prayer being answered
it's
and you having everything you need. The greatest prayer has already been answered,
right.
And that is salvation. So
yes.
We all have a reason. No matter where you are, what you're going through, you can look up and be grateful and thankful because of what God did and what Jesus did.
Right.
He gave his life. He paid the price. And all you have to do is receive and believe of what happened on the cross.
Just believe
so
his promises.
That's where the gratitude comes from.
Right.
Right? And then all the other extra things that he does for us, our health and strength, to be clothed in our right minds. You know, the Bible said he has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a
sound
mind.
Yes,
you know, what would you say to people that maybe are dealing with anxiety or worry or worrying about something during the holiday season?
To stop now and give it to God.
Give it to God.
Yeah. You can't fix it.
That's good.
You can't fix it, but God can.
That's good.
And he promised he would.
He promised he would.
Yeah.
So if we quit being anxious about it and trying to fix it and give it to him and leave it there.
Yeah.
And if you get up and don't leave it there the first time, go back and do it again and leave it there because that's what you have to do.
Right.
If he's going to fix it, you got to give it to him.
Mm-hmm. And I think this is so important that we land here for a minute and talk about this because I think that is probably the number one thing that our world is dealing with, the stress and the anxiety. People are really searching for peace.
Yes.
And here in Jesus, even our message we heard not too long ago, when you receive Jesus, you really receive the Prince of Peace. That's who he is, you know?
Right.
And so we say leave it to him, but how do you do that? How do we leave?
I think you have to continue to pray.
It's through prayer.
Because in the Bible, the scripture that right after it says, be anxious for nothing, the alternative is to pray.
But in
not everything. And when you do that, it says the peace comes. And so sometimes I know we all can be guilty of worrying about things or being nervous. Right. And it's just kind of these thoughts swirling in our head and we forget to stop and be like, oh, maybe I should actually pray about this. And I think that's how you give it to God. You continue to bring it to him. You invite him into the situation. You ask him for wisdom. And even just verbalizing it to the Lord and kind of getting it off your chest, I do think that's where the exchange comes.
There you go. That's good.
And he gives you the peace. So right. I think that's how you give burdens to the Lord, is through prayer. So I think the key to helping with, you know, lowering the levels of anxiety is to up your prayer.
Right. Up your prayer. Time.
That's good.
That's very what works good. For me.
That's good.
That's what works for all of us.
That's yeah. what the Bible says. So when you say, must be right.
So like you said, when you pray and you still feel it, don't just stop. Go back.
Go back.
Keep, yeah. That's why the Bible says pray without ceasing.
Keep praying.
Right. Because it's always things that are going to come and try to steal that peace. Mm-hmm. But he said, if you keep your mind stayed on me, mm-hmm. I'll keep you in perfect peace.
Yeah. Yeah. So be anxious for nothing.
Be anxious for nothing.
Yeah, and to meditate on the word.
The good things,
Because I think you have to be intentional. You have to kind of interrupt your thoughts. You have to stop. You have to actually pray, like, out loud. Because it doesn't say thinking about it is going to bring peace. It says pray about everything. And then choose to meditate on a scripture that, you know, ties in a promise for whatever it is
whatever
that
you're
needing.
Through.
Yeah, whatever you're desiring, whatever it is that's happening. So I think prayer and then having scriptures ready to think about and meditate on. And let
to
that
read.
Be kind of what takes up your thoughts as opposed to the issue or the problem. Like, because you said you can't fix it. You don't have the power to do it all on your own. Mm-hmm. You need God to intervene.
Right.
So I think that's
awesome. So Ashley, let's switch it over to you now. What are you grateful for this season?
I'm definitely grateful for delicious food. especially now.
While you're talking.
I'm grateful for my family. I'm grateful for you two. I'm grateful for the expanding of my family and another little baby to love on and kiss
yes.
on.
Yes.
She's actually moving right now.
Is she?
Yeah, she Hi, likes these
girl.
Tomatoes.
So we have another generation at the table with us. Another
yes.
generation girl.
She would
female.
Like to say a few words. No, I'm just kidding. I'm definitely grateful for the chance to have a daughter. You guys both you have two daughters. I'm sorry.
Three daughters.
And you have one.
One.
So what would you guys say is the best part about having
ask your grandmother, because she went through seven boys first. Then
yeah.
I came along.
I've heard they're a little more calm, not as hyper as the boys tend to be.
Definitely.
Oh,
they're
definitely.
After boys, they're a breeze.
I think because growing up, I wasn't like a girly girl. I was more of a tomboy.
Right.
I think like there's this expectation you have girls, you have to be like going on all the girl things.
That.
So I'm like,
I would put those.
She might want all that, but I'm not forcing any of that on her.
Those dresses with
ruffles
and she's like, I don't like
it.
I'm like, no, you have to like this.
I don't think I did bows.
No,
ever.
You didn't.
I was.
You would
just
take them out your hair.
Yeah. So we'll see.
She might not be like that. She might like her.
She might like all that stuff. I think a lot of women say like when you get older, it's fun to have like a, you know, shopping partner, go get your nails done, like those kinds of things. I'm like, yeah, that'll be fun. So I'm grateful just for the opportunity to get to now experience having a daughter after having a son. I'm of course, Jesus, I'm grateful for his peace, like we were just talking about. I just think peace is priceless, especially these days and all the uncertainty and all the craziness going on in the world. I'm just thankful for his peace that just remains and that doesn't fluctuate depending
the one sure thing.
What's happening in the world. just to get to spend time with family. We're going on our family vacation for Thanksgiving.
Right.
I'm looking forward to that.
Tell the people about that. So we normally
after Uncle Ronald passed away. We started feeling like we need to come together more, not just for a funeral or a wedding, but we started being intentional about having family reunions, and so it would take place during Thanksgiving, and we would do it every other year.
Right.
And we did it for a while.
Yeah.
And then we took a little break for I don't know how many years. So this is our first
time in
one back after, I don't know, 4 years. No, it's been more than 4 years. Because me and Auntie Debbie were talking.
It was really,
about it.
You've been married for how long?
Five.
So maybe it's been five.
It's been at least, no, it was been like even because me and Auntie Debbie just talked about this. Yeah, because she thought the same thing. She was like, well, your wedding is what kind of, and I was like, no, remember, it was years before I got married that we had our last reunion. Oh, really? We came up with the year, but I can't remember off the top of my head. But it's the first time we've all gotten together and done it.
That's the point.
For just the fact of like having a reunion, because you know we've seen each other over the years for different
But the
occasions.
Family's grown because you Wyatt is be his first time.
Yep, his first
and
time.
And then Joy,
Alvin just got married, so
just got
he
married.
Can bring his bride, new bride.
Is gonna come.
And yes, all of the extra kids
changes,
that are around.
That's right, extra kids because. Coconut and Monique.
Yeah, they have four now. I think the last time we did it, it was just three.
Little, right? It was just three.
I don't even think they had
girls. So the family keeps growing, but this year we're coming back together. And so that's exciting.
I'm grateful for that. So,
okay. Ashley, what are some ways that people can give back during this time? You know, we're talking about being thankful and we have gratitude, but it's, you know, we know that the Bible tells us it's more blessed to give than to receive, right? Mm-hmm. So what are ways that people can give back during this season, you think?
I think there's tons of ways. I know they have different, we have here in Nashville, the Rescue Mission. You can go and serve.
Yeah,
I think
which is probably in different cities everywhere.
Yeah, I'm sure wherever you are, there's opportunity to serve. And, you know, these are the times people tend to think about the less fortunate, which in return kind of makes them even more grateful for what they
do have. That's right.
Because it's all those things we take for granted, just like being able to go to the grocery store and buy food and have food in the house.
And everybody
can
do that.
And not stressing about that. So, at reaching out, asking if there's people in your church or on your job or friends or neighbors who might need help, like if they need a meal. I think there's a lot of little ways you can give back, just looking around you and you might not even know somebody around you is struggling.
I remember one Thanksgiving, I thought it was awesome. Debbie, you know, the family was over here and we had so much food.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think because growing up, you know, in a big family, you just feel like it might not be enough.
Right.
It might not be enough. And so I just remember the food that we prepared. And I never really could size it down when it came time for, you know, cooking for my family that was
It's hard to make Thanksgiving for a small number of people.
It's hard to make it for a small amount of people. But we had a lot of extra food and we made plates and we took it down to the homeless and and to me that just brought so much joy.
Yeah, that brings
so
joy.
It's
out
a
of
good
our
idea.
Excess, just having just realizing, man, we have more than
you
enough.
You have more than enough. So I think even going into that with the intentions on the front end that we're going to give to somebody else is a way that you can really have joy. And I'm speaking to a lot of people who don't have family, people who have lost their parents, and maybe they're by themselves, you know. Like you said, I think joining, making sure you're in a church community and seeing how you can serve. Because really, as we get older, you get that revelation. When I got that revelation that it really is more blessed to give than to receive, it changes everything.
Right. It does.
And you get so much more out of the holidays and every day when you start thinking about other people, because it's always, no matter what you're going through, it's always somebody who has it worse.
Right.
Yeah, and I think if maybe your church isn't doing anything, just do some research and find out what churches are doing something to benefit those who are in need during the holiday season and just be intentional about participating in any way you can.
Yeah, that's in our church, our mother's board usually goes through the church to find out who doesn't have enough if a certain person has a lot of children and they need a lot of help.
That's
we
good.
Pick their names so many families a year and see that they get what they need for Thanksgiving and Christmas.
Or even taking it a step further and inviting people into your house and having them
over for Thanksgiving. We've done that several times when people don't have family. So, it just makes it, I don't know, it just shows the love of God. And that's what every holiday season is about.
That's what it's about.
Is sharing the love of God,
you know. That's what it is.
So we're going to take a break. And when we come back, I'm going to talk about some of the things that I'm grateful for this year. Hope you guys are enjoying the show. I'm here at my home in the middle of a project, but you know, I just wanted to talk to you about family traditions. You know, family traditions is the thing that connects every generation. So they're so important that we cultivate them and that we don't lose them, that we don't lose them. You know, I'm so grateful for my parents because they were very intentional about teaching us what was important to keep us together, what was important in order to continue to walk in the ways of the Lord. And, you know, the holiday seasons was all about family, was about food. You know, my parents would sponsor us in concerts. We would do the Winans Christmas concerts. We would do Mother's Day concerts. And all of these things put something in us that understood the importance of coming together and doing something over and over and over again. And because of that, I understand with my children how important it is to create those moments, to create space for traditions, godly traditions, that will guarantee to bless every family member now until Jesus comes. Now that I have my own children, it's so important that we create those spaces and memories for traditions that will keep us grounded as a family, but most importantly, grounded in the things of the Lord. And then I have my first grandson, my first grandbaby, Wyatt, and I'm believing for more to come. But it's so important that I have it rooted and grounded in my children so that they can deposit that in Wyatt and in the next generation. And that's the way we continue being a strong family and a strong church. So remember, traditions are important. Welcome back. We are having an awesome time here. We started with the elevation of the food and we enjoyed. Did you enjoy the salad?
Yes.
Oh my goodness. Salad. Ashley, I think you almost finished all of yours.
Delicious.
And Chef Q is coming back to bless us again.
All right.
Hey. What do you have?
All right, guys, we got that salad out of the way.
Perfect.
So now we got the entrees. So I'm sitting down in front of you guys a cinnamon dusted pork tenderloin. It has smashed potatoes and house-made cranberry sauce.
Oh my goodness.
We talk about Thanksgiving, and everybody gets tired of turkey, Cece.
Okay,
so what I did here was we got pork tenderloin, and we cinnamon dusted it with house spices, smashed some potatoes, and I made that cranberry sauce just like my mama used to make it, Mom Winans. So I really hope you guys enjoy that. You guys take
we
care, all right?
Will.
All right.
God bless
awesome.
You. God bless you,
all.
Chef Q.
Many blessings
Remember, Q,
upon Chef Q.
Q 1227. If you're in the Sacramento
to fly to
area,
Sacramento.
You're going
to
be, yes, you do. It's worth the trip. It really is.
So while, you know, me and G Barbie get to indulge, why don't you tell us why you're thankful?
Okay.
Other than
All right.
me, of course.
I am grateful for so many things. Like Mom said, the number one thing is that I am saved. I know the Lord, and I am just so grateful. The older I get, the more grateful I am for that, period.
Amen.
Because that is the source where everything else comes
God,
from.
That's right.
But I'm grateful for my mom being here, 86 years now, right?
Yes.
Turned 86. She's looking amazing, and she's still such a blessing in our lives.
Yes.
She's still straightening us out when we're out of
yeah,
order.
Yeah, she got on your case
yeah,
earlier.
Yeah, today. I got in trouble today. And she's right. She's here. And now I have to go out of town. And I convinced her to come here a little earlier.
To cancel all
I can't believe you did that.
And my schedule, I'm going to.
Wow. I'm very disappointed
okay.
on some
things.
Well.
But she gets us and she forgives
here.
Us. Yeah, she has a
yeah,
lot. Yeah.
You do have
You got
others.
A lot of extra kids. So, so I'm grateful for her. I'm grateful for... Of course, my marriage, my husband, we've just been blessed. We've been blessed that peace in our home. We talked about peace earlier, so I'm grateful for that. Grateful for Ashley and Kenny and Wyatt.
And your grandchildren.
And now we grandchildren.
Mm, you can say your grandchildren.
I have a granddaughter.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my goodness. We're in trouble. We're in trouble. So I'm so grateful for that. Grateful that, oh, my goodness. One of your favorite people in the world got married
Oh, my
son, Alvin, we're all grateful. Got married. And Ashley, you have a sister.
I have a new sister-in-law.
A new sister, Jasmine, and she's beautiful inside and out. And so I'm just happy for this phase of Alvin's life to get a chance to experience marriage. And mm-hmm. I'll have some more grandbabies, Lord's will. Grateful for the church, Nashville Life, my church family, the body of Christ family.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, they have prayed for me. And this fall, I got a chance to go on tour. It's been so many years since I've gone on tour.
Your tour, first tour in many years.
Yeah, we stopped off in Michigan and was on your birthday.
On my birthday.
Yes.
What did you think of the show?
Be honest.
It was wonderful.
You said be honest.
Wonderful.
It was incredible. It's been incredible.
Yes, it was.
I want to say thank you to everybody who came. We went to 20 cities in the fall. And we're going to be touring again this spring. And
I'll have to try to make one of the spring shows.
Yeah, yeah. Well, your babies do what?
The beginning end of March.
End of March. So
well, I have to make at least one because I didn't get to make any.
Yeah.
When is this new tour starting?
In the spring of 2023.
Oh, okay.
I'll finish some of the cities.
Well, in March.
Yeah, we'll start around that time, but. But I was so grateful for everybody who came out because everybody came out really ready to worship. Mom, you know, it wasn't a concert that you came to. We had a service.
The people were all in.
And I was worried if my voice was going to, you know, hold up. But most of the concerts, really, everybody sang everything for me.
Great.
Thank you all. but it was awesome. I had a great time, and God really moved. And people were ready to get out. You know, since the pandemic, people are ready to experience life again.
Mm-hmm.
And not, you know, we've been so isolated, but the tour allowed people to get out and come and bless the Lord together.
Right.
And, you know, it's wonderful when we praise God individually, but it's nothing like that corporate expression.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty awesome. So we have a few recaps. You know, we have a video
that we can
show some highlights. Well, all of it was a highlight, but
just
but we have something for those of you who weren't able to make it. Or we didn't come to your city, we have something to show you so that you can experience a little bit of what we experienced.
Concert. Let me tell you what happened. I had to go get an MRI. I was afraid to get in the machine, right? I said, put on gospel music. They put on gospel music, and guess what was playing? Believe for it. Listen, God is faithful. Even in an MRI exam, God spoke to me through CC, so that's why I'm here. God is good. Oh, I'm just excited. God is good. He's good. And he's a healer, no cancer. So God is a keeper. Yes,
awesome.
He is.
Yes,
thank you so much.
Thank you, Jesus.
My prayer tonight is that God will be glorified and that the world will come to know who he is.
Since PTL.
this room tonight. So y'all have to understand, I thank you guys because you've been with me a long time. Yeah. You allow me to be a part of your life, allow me to ride in the car with you and to go through some rough times. Yeah. You've trusted our ministry, and I am forever grateful to you. I am forever, ever grateful. You see, when BB and I started on PTL, I was 17 years old. And I just turned 58 a couple of weeks ago. So y'all, we've been hanging out a while. But God has been faithful. And I want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart, hub. You've embraced my family and myself over the years. I do not take it lightly. And I love you for it. And I appreciate you for it. And I just want to keep doing whatever God wants me to do as long as he wants me to do it. So give yourselves a hand for me tonight.
You were phenomenal. Words cannot express how you blessed us. And I am believing for it in Jesus' name. I pray for the blessings of your entire tour. Bless you, Cece. Yeah!
Thank you so much for all that you do for my generation and generations to come. Thank you so much. I love you.
Hi, Cece. This is Gail. I've been listening to you and BB for over 40 years. It took me until now that God blessed me to see you. And I was hoping and praying that BB walked in, but he didn't. But Cece, glory be to God. Thank you for finally seeing your face. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Hello, Pastor Cece. This is Kevin Thorne. Can you tell hello?
Hi.
And I'm Darlene Thorne. We came to your church May of 2021. And it was at that service that we got the opportunity to speak with you. And you prayed for my husband who had suffered a stroke back in 2019. And I want you to see what your prayers have done. Your prayers have encouraged him, and he is walking better, talking better, moving. And it's because you prayed for him, you prayed for our daughter Kennedy, and our lives have not been the same. And because of your yes, my husband is standing here today, and we are able to praise God for his healing touch. Thank you so much, Pastor Cece. We love you.
Wonderful. You know, one of the things about touring is you meet some of the greatest people who have supported you throughout the years. And yes. Mom, you know, decades. We were talking about when we first started out, and you and Dad.
You
sponsored us in concert. You saw what you felt really God had gave us. And so you guys put your money into putting us in concerts during the holiday seasons, right? Every holiday, Mother's Day and Thanksgiving or really Christmas. Yeah, at the University College. And they would sit back and say, I wonder if anybody gonna come see our kids.
How did you get the word out about these shows? Did you just have flyers? Was it word of mouth?
We had flyers.
Oh yeah, they worked it.
Had it announced.
That's really sweet.
And we prayed that they would come.
And prayed.
Let the people
and
come.
And prayed.
And they came.
But it was awesome. Came. It was awesome. And speaking of awesome, was this food incredible? Look at Ashley's plate. Chef Q, come on in.
How was everything?
Was
everything all right?
Put a cover over
it was
this.
Amazing. She wanted to finish her. She loved it.
I cleaned my plate. The baby really liked it.
She said the baby.
And I was just telling him, I don't even eat cranberries. I never eat cranberries.
Well, I'm so glad you enjoyed those. Well, it's been great. Thank you guys for inviting me over.
Oh, thank you.
I'm so thankful for you guys. It's been awesome.
Is there dessert? I'm ready for dessert.
Maybe after the show.
Well, I appreciate you guys so much. Thank you
so much.
We love you guys.
This was amazing. Talking about elevating. Anything else you want to say about Thanksgiving?
I'm just thankful for you all being in our lives. Thankful for God, but thankful for you guys being in our lives. It's awesome. And come back out to Sacramento, Roseville area. Visit the restaurant again.
I'm booking my flight today.
I appreciate it. Thank you guys, Mom. I love you so much.
Thank you,
guys.
Thank you.
That was so delicious.
So good. And so we're so grateful. And we all know there's no way we can go through everything we're grateful for, because there's too many blessings.
Too many to count.
But there's one more that I want to share.
Another one.
That's right. Every day, new blessings every morning, right? New mercies every morning. So one more I want to share is, and that is Believe For It book.
Wow.
It is out, and Mom was like, "Do I have one?" And I'm like, "Of course you do. This is for you."
Have a copy?
But
where's
I'm
my copy?
I'm gonna give you a copy too.
I guess you can have that.
She's the queen.
Yeah, you
but
get
I'm
it
really
first.
Grateful. It's out now. And Mom, it just talks about really you and all the your generation, what you sacrificed for us. You know, we're here today. Ashley's here. We got another one coming, but we know who we are because of you. You took Praise out the God. Time to pour into us. And
yes,
so
thank you.
This book is to encourage everybody, really, especially those my age and older. You're not done yet. There's so much more that you can pour. It's somebody around you can pour into.
Absolutely.
You know, and when you do that, then you affect every generation. God wants to make a greater impact through your life. And so Believe For It. I'm so grateful. Everybody who helped me do this, and especially Suzanne Gosselin. She was the writer that helped me get this thing together, the ghostwriter. She's amazing. And so I just pray that this book will bless you to really be grateful and to be thankful for what God has already done and what he's going to continue to do. Thank you for joining us on Generations. Happy Thanksgiving. And we love you.
See you next time.
Yeah.
And don't forget to like and subscribe. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. To go, please, all right. For tomorrow.
We'll take another round,
hey,
please. Seconds.
Q. Mama trying to get a to-go plate.
For tomorrow.
Huh?
More in there.
Oh, she said she wanted to go. She gonna she wanna make sure she got some. It's so good.
Delicious.